Hey guys, I'm in Brittany, France now. Just arrived here in the night, like 3 p.m. or something, after 7 long hours drive from Paris. And yeah, it was a long drive. Had some hail, snow and rain at the way. When I arrived, I instantly fell asleep here at the front seat, and now I just woke up here to a wonderful sight. Crystal clear blue water, some rocky islands. And sand flats between that, it's perfect. And now I'm just waiting for the low tide to be at minimum, so I can go out. And then when it's rising, the sea bass will come in to feed on the small fish. I just have to gear up, put my waders on, and then you will see some sea bass action in 1, 2, 3. So boys, my GoPro mic unfortunately went dead, so I'm speaking here right now, and that's it. I'm walking on these flats where there was once water. There's some very high and very low tides in Brittany, like 6 to 9 meters. And I've actually been here before. 3 years ago, I went with a friend here to Brittany, and we really struggled to catch the bigger fish on the outer coast by the cliffs. And then we found this little small estuary, or would you call it a cove perhaps. And I know there's fish in here. A bit smaller fish, but there's loads of fish. So I'm fishing with a light tackle and a small swim bait, as you see here, around 7 centimeters. Fished with an offset hook and a bullet weight. Feel this setup is more agile. You can fish between rocks, close to the bottom, and in weeds as well. The rod I use is a Western spinning rod, 7 to 21 grams, and the reel, as you may know, Nazca 1000, spooled with 0.12 braid. The tide here in Brittany is just insane. The tidal change is 6 meters in just 6 hours, and as you see in this time lapse, it's only 1 hour time lapse here, and the water just rises like crazy. Therefore, the tidal change have enormous effect on sea bass hunting patterns. And as you see in these pictures, the water is high at this point. Anyways, I'll go just between these two islands. This is where the water will be sewing in, and all the prey will just be pushed up against the low water. And this is where the sea bass will be feeding. It's mostly smaller fish that you find in here, but you can also find fish to 50, like 60 centimeters or so. And they come in here to feed on shrimps and small cutthroats. I don't know if you can see it on these pictures, but... Well, I arrived to the island, and I'm just about to have my first cast. Just casting my little swim bait out and ripping it a bit fast in, because they like fast action, and then some spin stops. Well, the first spot didn't produce anything, so I'm just moving on. And as you see here in this picture, the rocks are very slippery, so I really have to be careful not to fall. And I'm taking my first cast, second cast actually here, and spinning in, and well, hooked up to the first fish of the trip. I'm so sad that you can't hear the real excitement of the clip, but this is really excitement for me. I've just drove 7 hours and I got my first sea bass. Really awesome. I know it's a small sea bass, but it's a sea bass. And here I'm just close to getting the fish in, and I'm so excited at this point. And as you look here, look at this fish. Beautiful. I just love sea bass. Pure silvery scales, and this nice spiny sail they have on the back, and yeah, I just love sea bass so much. Caught on this little swim bait here. Fish takes a style and release, awesome. And moving on, got just on the top of the island here, and look at this amazing view. Brittany is just so beautiful. The water has risen a bit now, and I'm casting out, fishing in thick weed, seaweed here, and it's good I'm using a Texas rig, otherwise I would have hooked all this weed. And I'm just spinning in, ripping, 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 making some spin stops, and then, oh, hooked up, and just in the fall, in the drop, when I make this spin stop, and it actually feels like a very good bass, but it's the same size again. But it really doesn't matter, because I love catching sea bass. Doesn't matter what the size is, and pound for pound, they're actually very good fighting fish. And just getting it in here. Look at this beautiful fish again. Little small cute fish, and release. Cha-ching. That was the last sea bass here from Brittany. I really had two awesome days exploring all these small islands. If you like this video, even though my mic died, please hit the like button. Next up is bass fishing in France. If you want to follow those adventures, please subscribe my channel. Otherwise, see you on the next time, guys.